Well, let's see some games. What do we have here? We have Niv-Megas Elemental and Hidden Strings. That's a game plan. Let's see if this can actually work. Temple of Triumph, so that probably means red, white, burn. Well then, I guess I just have to hope that this Niv-Megas Elemental survives. Otherwise, we're not really doing anything. But if it does survive, and we can get all these hidden strings off, then it's gonna be good. No. Well, there goes the game plan. Ah, Tormented Hero. An alternative carrier for all these hidden strings. Ooh, I don't think so. Triton Tactics is good in a format where people are playing Searing Blood. And now we can set up some sweet action with the Hidden Strings. Let's see, how is this gonna work? So I can target this and my island. I don't want to tap the hero, but I do want to untap the island and cipher onto it. And then cast the next hidden strings. Oh yeah. I don't want to tap my hero, but I do want to untap my island and cipher onto it. Yep. Then we attack. Get some more hidden strings. Cipher action. Target my hero. Untap something. Well, this was just a beautiful turn. Absolute perfection. Look at that. He went from, I think it was at 19 before, down to 13. All these heroic triggers, I gained a bunch of life. And even if he wants to try to burn out my Tormented Hero, I still have it untapped, so I can bounce it back with the Retraction Helix. Yay! Yeah, he might be interested in burning my Tormented Hero. You might also very well just have all Skullcracks and Boros Charms in hand, in which case he cannot target it. I just have to try. If he has another way to target my creature, then that's unfortunate, and I will be sitting with some useless Retraction Helix. Yep, well, too bad. But not attacking at all, and then eventually dying to Skullcrack and Boros Charm, or possibly War Leader's Helix, also didn't seem like the best. So now, well, I'm still in okay shape. I mean, I'm at 25 life, which is definitely good against the burn deck. I have, well, some useless cards in hand for the moment, but if I draw another Tormented Hero, or maybe a Niv-Megas Elemental, then I can turn all of this nonsense into relevant effects. So yeah, I should still be okay. Necromancer. Fine. If he wants to kill it, then I have the Mizzium skin. He likes me. Okay. Still at 16. It's a healthy life total. Springleaf Drum, another completely useless card. I gotta say that I'm trying to win this game in kind of a handicapped way. I have so many nonsense cards in my hand that don't do anything at all. But at the same time, he's just trying to burn me out. And I gained so much life from my Tormented Hero that maybe my Xetrid Necromancer can just raise his burn spells. Now there's a Painseer as well. That should be okay. Especially since I can just tab it with the Springleaf Drum. Oh yeah. All the value. Of course, against a burn deck, getting this trigger off is not exactly where you want to be, but I'm not going to say no to a free card. Not when I'm still at 13 and in no huge danger of dying. Not yet. I'll take that. One life loss for a Emysium skin. Guess I'll start off with the artisan. Because if he tries to block some of my creatures with his Mutavolt, then maybe I can turn this into Exedrid Necromancer, get some value. Yeah, still going well. Is this another War Leader's Helix starting me? Yep, you got it. Do I want to play the Helix already? I guess it will allow me to turn my Artisan into another Exedrid Necromancer, which is good. There's no real point in doing it already, I think. Yeah, I can wait. That is going to be one big Niv-Magus Elemental. Just have to be careful that I don't just die here to some removal spells and attacks by his Mutavolts. Oh, yeah, I don't mean removal spells, burn spells. I guess what I can do is like play the Niv-Magus Elemental and then just attack with the Artisan and the Necromancer. And if he doesn't block, then I will turn the Artisan into a Niv-Magus Elemental and just eat a bunch of things. Yeah, that should be okay. And I still have some good blockers back for his Mutavolts. I don't tap the Pain Seer, so I'm in no risk of dying to that. He didn't block. So let's see. I guess I will Retraction Helix my Artisan. Make this become an Niv-Magus Elemental. Then after that resolves with the Helix still on the stack, I will eat the Helix. Adding. I could do some more, but I think it's better to keep the Mizium skin up, or maybe an ultimate prize in case he has Chandos Phoenix. Because one way or another, I threaten lethal on the next turn anyway. Yeah, I don't want to be tapping my paints here at this point. Agent of the Fates, it could be useful. Let's play it. So what can he have here? I mean, he can try to block, but then I will just target my agent to make him sacrifice something and then eat those cards with an Niv-Magus Elemental. Maybe if he has War Leader's Helix and then like gains life, survives the combat, and I die to my own Pain Seer. Maybe that's one way to possibly lose this game. So I guess I'll keep the Pain Seer back just in case. I mean, I think I got him here, but we'll see. So I need to hold control so I can respawn to my own spells and eat the Mizium skin. Because obviously I'm not really interested in, well, the effect. I just wanted to get the heroic trigger and make a bigger Niv-Magus Elemental. Gotta say, this deck is a lot of fun to play. All the sweet triggers, the crazy Artisan of Forms interactions. Mm-hmm. Sure. Well, let's force him to sacrifice first. Then I think I'm just gonna do this once more. What's the worst that can happen? The War Leader's Helix, I guess, or something. A ding. If he has nothing, then he's just dead. Super dead. And it doesn't look like he has anything. Yay! Got there. Man, this deck is a lot of fun. So playing against Red White Burn, then all these Dispel should be good, Negate should be good, Duress should be good, Demon also, a solid clock when he's trying to burn us out, and well, we can just attack with the Demon, also blocks his Chandra's Phoenix. To board out, I don't think Retraction Helix is doing it. I mean, it allowed me to target my heroic creatures on a previous game, but the effect is kind of irrelevant. Boon of Erebos, I don't think that's where I want to be, since I don't want to be losing life against this deck. Ultimate Prize cannot even kill Mutavolt, so that's out. And then I guess Painseer is a bit dangerous, for obvious reasons, against a deck with all kinds of burn spells, Hidden Strings. Is probably not where I want to be, since I don't think I will be tapping down many permanents on his side of the board. I mean, it was kind of sweet with all the Tormented Hero and all the nonsense, but in the end, it was just a very small life swing and didn't do all that much. And then one other card. I guess I'll take out another Hidden Strings, even though this is kind of what the deck is trying to do. Nah. The pain's here. I mean, this deck is built around Hidden Strings. So if you start taking it out, then you're going against what this deck is made and set up to do. Yep, doing it like this.